Hello, everybody. I'm Johnny McCobb, the creep of the class. I'm here at Horror News Net TV to go over the latest trailer for the newest Hellraiser film. This can only end in tears. If you notice, I'm looking a little bit different. I have hair color to match the color of my black little heart now. Just got that done yesterday. It's actually the first time I've ever dyed my hair. So let's dive right into this. So we've got Hellraiser Judgment. Now, this is the 10th Hellraiser film. Now, the first two films, you know, adapted by from Clive Barker's novella, the Hellbound Heart, and actually brought to life by Clive Barker himself, were just sheer masterpieces, true classics of the horror genre. 3 and 4, in my opinion, were also very good. They didn't match up with the first two. From there, they just kind of went downhill. Now, one consistency of the series that we've had up until part 8 was the brilliant horror icon Doug Bradley playing Pinhead in every film. Pinhead, of course, being the lead Cenobite, the guy with all the pins in his head. Nails, actually, but whatever. Anyway, I digress. By the time they came out with the current most recent one, Hellraiser Revelations, Doug himself just couldn't bring himself to reprise the role when they're not even trying anymore. And they really aren't. Hellraiser Revelations was essentially an ashcan film that actually was released. Similar to the 1994 Fantastic Four movie, the only reason it was even made was so that they could hold on to the, so that Dimension could continue to hold on to the rights to Hellraiser, because if you don't use them, you lose them. So they made this cheap piece of crap, horrible, horrible, horrible movie, and they put it out there. A lot of times when these types of movies are made, they're kind of just shelved, but they actually released this one, and it was bad. It was very bad. It brought us just so many bad things. Fat face Pinhead comes to mind. As I said, Doug Bradley did not play the role, so they replaced him. And this will be the second Hellraiser film without Doug. So let's take a look at this trailer, see what sort of travesty we're in for.
From the depths of hell, an unspeakable evil! Will reclaim his dominion!
Evil seeks evil.
What is going on here?
Let's just dive in, shall we?
What we're investigating?
I am a jealous guy.
Just curious. What do you see?
You think you're too close to this case?
Jesus Christ.
It's him.
What on earth is this place?
It isn't.
Hellraiser Judgment. Okay, and that's supposed to come out next month at some point. So let's dive right into this. So, Hellraiser Judgment. Detectives Sean and David Carter are on the case to find the gruesome serial killer terrorizing the city, joining forces with Detective Christian Egerton. They dig deeper into a spiraling maze of horror that may not be of this world. So let's take a look at what we got in here. See, so we got, this is written and directed by Gary J. Tunnicliffe. This is a guy who is predominantly a makeup artist. Now, he's got 95 makeup department credits. Let's see. Scream, the TV series, Burying the X, Scary Movie 5, Piranha 3DD, Straw Dogs, Apollo 18, X-Men Origins, Wolverine, Pulse 3, 2, White Noise 2, Pulse, Return of the Living Dead. So he's got quite the accomplished career in the makeup department here. Now, taking a look at writing directing, he's written 10 items, directed 6. I've not seen any of these films that he has directed. Actually, no, I guess. Okay, so I know I saw Chicken Run when I was a kid, and I guess that was adapted by from a short story that he did, a short film. Nope. That is a short horror film. So never mind there. all right, so now the disturbing thing is that we see here that he was also the writer for the ill-fated Hellraiser Revelations. Now, that's not automatically a reason to jump to any sort of negative conclusions. I mean, it's entirely possible he had written, like, the best script in the world, and they just butchered it. Much as, like, what had happened with Alien Resurrection, let's say. But still, yeah, there's not a lot of experience there. I'm kind of curious. This is already screaming like they're really just trying to hold on to the rights again. But let me see. This is our pinhead. This is our pinhead this time. Paul T. Taylor. Never heard of this guy before. And he's done next to nothing I'm familiar with. Okay, so I've seen Super. That was an awesome movie. I'm not sure what character Frank Sr. was. I've seen Sin City, of course, but I don't remember Assistant DA. So, I mean, this is basically, this is a nobody. I'm not trying to insult the guy, but he's not a name, that's for sure. I mean, it looks like he's making a career of it. He's finding jobs. But, I mean, I haven't seen any of this stuff. Well, and it doesn't look like he has a thing for horror films. Which is making me wonder why he has suddenly chosen to try to be Pinhead. Now, I mean, we didn't see a lot of Pinhead in that trailer, so the kind of verdict is still out as to whether it's going to be a decent rendition of the character. Or shit, like it was last time. So only time will tell. Now, the interesting item on the cast list, probably the only interesting name involved in the movie that I'm aware of, is Heather Langenkamp. Heather is, of course, best known as Nancy from the Nightmare on Elm Street films. She was Nancy in 1 and 3, and played herself in Wes Craven's New Nightmare. And she has since done a couple other horror things. Like Shocker. She really hasn't been heavily involved in acting in a while. Like, you can see here, she kind of tapered off in the 90s to early 2000s. And she's recently picked up again. But this is her first involvement in any Hellraiser movie. So it's very interesting to see that. Like, I want to know, I'm wondering if she, like, approached them or if they approached her. I don't know. It's interesting. I'll definitely see it, if only because Heather's in it. So I guess that marketing ploy worked. Because I definitely do want to see more, movies with Heather Langenkamp. I mean, she's awesome. All right. So let's take a look at this thing again. Turn down the volume a little bit so you guys can hear me a little bit better. First off, this is just pure cheese. It's so cliche. Just this, we'll return to reclaim its dominion. It's ridiculous.
Evil seeks evil.
So it looks like we get a new rendition of the twin Cenobites that we last saw in 4. I like the guy with the cuts all over his face. That's really cool. I do like that. I want to see more of that guy. I want to find out what the hell his story is. Now, this film looks like it's getting away from more of the slasher genre that the series kind of fell into after 3.
It's him.
What on earth is this place?
So that's a positive. That's getting more into the visceral, psychological aspect of things. Now this dude looks fucking awesome. Looks like he's like some giant baby Cenobite thing. I always love new Cenobites. Looks like a return of the pillar.
There's hell to pay.
This thing is so cool. I like that thing. Okay, I'm gonna say I like that thing. Whatever the hell that thing is, it could be my new friend. Hellraiser Judgment. So we're not really getting any sort of real idea of the story here. They basically just showed us a lot of random scenes. They showed us some new Cenobites, a lot of blood, and some crime scene stuff. That's about all we have to work on off of the trailer itself. And surprisingly enough, they're really, being that she's the biggest name that they're banking on in this movie, Heather was not in that trailer much at all, which was kind of bizarre. You would think I'm sure she was probably the highest paid individual on the cast, you would think they'd want to put her face in there and, you know, make the most of that investment. But it doesn't appear that they have done that. So that's kind of questionable. Now, this movie comes out next month. I want to say, I know it's February 13th or 18th. I can't remember which. And I'll take a look at it and I'll review it and I'll probably tear it to shreds most likely. So we'll see what happens there. Woohoo, just beating the dead horse some more. I mean, don't get me wrong, I love Hellraiser. Hellraiser is one of my favorite franchises out there. But it's just, the movies are just dying. I mean, there's some fantastic comic books that even up until recently, they were still putting out. There's some great short stories out there. I actually have an anthology book called Hellbound Hearts, plural, which is just a series of short stories written by a ton of different prolific authors. Set in the Hellraiser universe, and that's a fantastic book. If you want, good Hellraiser stories, it might be time to look beyond the cinema aspect of it. You might want to look into some of the comics, look into some of the books. It's a very rich universe. There's a lot of mythos to it, and I mean, just I love all the different Cenobites and like their backstories and just how they become twisted basically, by their own sins and stuff. That's really cool to me. But anyway, once again, I'm Johnny McCobb, the Creep of the Class. I'm here at Horror News Net TV. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. I will see you all next time.